Good morning. It's Lisa with Soulshine, and it's morning tea with me. So I have my tea, my to-go mug, because I'm off to Bible study at church this morning, and we're digging into Acts. But I wanted to jump on real quick. I didn't have a chance to jump on yesterday because I had meeting yesterday, and I read something the evening before that really kind of like ruffled my feathers a little bit. And I don't soapbox much here because I feel like there's enough opinion making in the world. But I read something that really, really poked the bear a little bit. And it was from a homeschooling Facebook page. And first of all, Facebook in general has just become this terrible place, successful yuckiness. I think it's our duty to kind of add some salt and light back to it, but that's a side story. Anyway, I was scrolling past a homeschool group that I follow, and somebody had posted about how Kanye has now joined forces with Joel Osteen, and I was like, wow, that's a pretty impressive combination, collaboration. And you know how Facebook shows you like the top three comments or whatever? They were the most insidious, hateful comments I've ever read. And I wish that I hadn't read them because it really poked the bear. And I'm so offended and that they represent me as a Christian, as a homeschool person. The things that they said were ridiculous, that Joel, that they're not a big fan of Joel Osteen, he's a heretic. Well, I had to look up heretic because Sister didn't have that in my data bank. I mean, I've said it and heard it before, but I had to look it up to refresh my brain. It means somebody that doesn't go along with the traditionally accepted dogma or belief system that everyone else believes. Well, gosh, I don't want to believe necessarily what everybody else believes, so I'm kind of a Joel Osteen fan. If he points people back to the big guy, he's okay by me. And then another person had said, you know, that Kanye is talking to thousands of people, more than that, actually, and he's not been trained. Well, last I checked, and I'm not a scholar here, but the disciples weren't trained. They were fishermen. They were just normal Joes putting their nets out every day, and they decided to follow the big guy. So the fact that he's got to be trained, to me, it seems like, from what I remember, the guys that were actually trained were the ones that did the most harm. They weren't the heroes of the story. So my point is, let's not be so judgy and discount something that maybe God is using for good. And if you haven't listened to his album, I suggest you give it a listen. I downloaded it. I love it. I swear, and I don't swear often, it is the most Holy Spirit reigned lyrics I've ever heard. It's incredibly moving and inspiring, and it's spoken with truth and honesty more than I've heard anything in a very, very long time. Any of the worship songs I've heard in a long time. It is anointed and appointed and perfect in time such as this. So if you haven't downloaded the album, definitely give it a listen before you throw stones and judge and he's not trained and you know, he's following a heretic and blah, blah, blah. Just give it a listen. I think God can use anything. And my goodness, if you looked into my past, I shouldn't even be able to put my face out here or leave the house. I should be in bed 24/7 under the covers and under my pillow because I've done horrible things just like everybody else has. So my point is to stop being so judgy. And use your own Holy Spirit judgment. Don't talk to your friends about what they think. Listen to it and follow in line with what you know about the big guy and take what you love and throw away the rest and be a big girl about it. Be your own girl about it. Don't follow the rest of the world and give people a chance because my gosh, if he can use Kanye, which I haven't been a fan of for many years because I always thought that he was very self-centered and but gosh, aren't so many of us. But now look what he's, you know, what the big guy's done in his heart and now he's using him for good things. So I don't know, I'd say give it a listen. Don't be so judgy. Check yourself before you wreck yourself. And that's what I have to say about that. So I'm gonna jump off my soapbox now. Take what you love, ignore the rest, and check it out yourself before you get all judgy and throw stones. Because you're hurting other people too, because people that are fragile and curious read your comments and then they decide not to check it out at all, or even be less curious about the big guy because you're representing so poorly. So I'm gonna jump off my soapbox and know that whatever you're doing today, I hope that you know I'm sending you much love, and I hope you have a most marvelous day. Love you much. Mwah, mwah, mwah.